Greetings, my fellow ape descendant life forms, and welcome back to yet another episode of How to Spend Your Time in the Lockdown when your mom is busy browsing Facebook on the computer and you only have a smartphone at your disposal. A little too specific, eh? Now, just like the beautiful orangutan in my city zoo, I am a lazy creature. So this will be the second last video in the series. Without wasting any precious time, let's get started. Now, where were we? Snappy cinnamons? If you were curious enough to go through the last few videos, you'll know we use the phrase love.graphics a lot. To aid our aforementioned laziness, we'll assign the whole phrase to this LG. The second thing we'll need to do is define a global variable time. We'll add the value of DT or delta time in the update function to the time. Why? Math. Now the last thing to set up is our screen dimensions. We'll store them in SX and SY like so. As you can see, we already set up a basic scene management system from the previous video. Coming to scene1.lua file, we'll create the most basic title screen. In fact, so basic that even grandma can play a game. We'll define a variable to store the title image. This will contain a title and some sensible instructions to start the game. We'll also define an X and Y position for the title and set them to the middle of the screen. Now, we'll draw the title at the given position, but we'll add the sign of time to the Y value and multiply it by some amount. What does that do? This. Setting up so any touch takes us to the next scene, we'll move to scene2.lua. But before that, let's fix the scaling of our game so that Granny can at least see the darn thing. I use this little trick to make sure that the height of the screen is what I want. We'll update the screen dimensions and the draw function. With that done, let's add a few images to scene 2 and draw them to the screen. Voila! Now we'll make it so the foreground scrolls to give a sense of motion. For that, we'll have to move the foreground backwards and fill the gap with a duplicate of the image. However, we can use a little something Love2D offers, known as quads. These allow us to draw sections of an image, but we'll use it to draw a repeated tile of the image. In the code, we'll set up the quad to have the same height but twice the width as the image. We'll include the quad in the draw call along with an X position, from which we'll keep on subtracting a given speed. Once the X position is midway across the screen, we'll reset it to its original. And abracadabra, grandma can be deceived. Time to bake some big eggs. I don't know if it's French or not. But before that, a little crash course of object-oriented programming for all the uninitiated brothers out there. In real life, we can group together some objects based on their category. In the same way, we can have multiple objects of the same class in our game. These objects have a set of attributes like its name, shape, etc., as well as some methods or functions that they can do. Classes and objects can be very useful in games, not only because they're full of objects that share properties, but also because it helps keep the code clean and organized. Let's jump right into it then, shall we? We'll create a new file and call it bagel.lua. We'll define the bagel class as a table and define a function called new that we'll use to create new objects of the class. A bit familiar to the scene setup, I know. In the function, we'll define our object as a local and also as a parameter in case we need to duplicate our object. Then, we'll add these two lines of code. Now, what exactly they do is out of the scope of this video, but basically we're passing on the functions and variables of the class to the object. After that, it's time to define some properties. Now, remember, the properties of an object can either be shared amongst the objects, like grandma's love, or private, like grandma's secret recipe. She just won't tell. Coming back to our bagel, we want the image and the gravity to be shared, and the position and velocity to be private or separate for each object. Finally, we want to return our newly created object. Let's create a couple of functions for the bagel, namely the update and the draw. In the update function, let's add gravity to our velocity and then add our velocity to our y position. In the draw function, we'll call lg.draw, and in the parameters, we'll pass in the image, the position, the angle set to 0, the scale left at 1, and the anchors set to the middle of the image. Now let's set a position to the middle of the screen and head over to scene2.lua. Here, we'll create an instance of the bagel and call its update and draw functions in the respective places. And bonjour, here we have a bagel. Now, this means we can easily create multiple instances of the class with just a few lines of code. Let's define another function jump that sets the velocity to a given value and call this function in the touch input function of our scene. Do note that we're using the colon instead of a dot because we want to pass the bagel object itself to the function. Good jolly, our bagel can jump! Now, to add a little juice to our game, Let us define another variable angle and add 1 degree to it every update. Make sure to convert it to radians because Love2D for some reason doesn't like degrees. In the jump function, we'll set the angle to minus 30 degrees, also convert it to radians. And sweet jolly, our bagel can even grow. You get the idea. Let's add ground collision to our bagel. For that, we'll define a Y position 20 pixels above the bottom of the screen. And in the update function, make sure the bagel doesn't go beyond it by using math.min. In case you're even half as curious as my neighbors, you'll notice that a bagel is practically invincible, and in this world only one granny can hold that power. So let us find a way to kill our newborn bagel. For that, we'll define a property alive, which we'll set to true by default, unless you're me. After that, we'll add conditions to the activities that can only be done when the bagel is, well, alive. To end, we'll check if the bagel goes off screen or touches the ground, and if it does, we'll set alive to false. Whew, that's it for this video. Now, you may be asking, but BHGD, why so late in posting a video? Well, I was just busy and definitely not sleeping on it. And you may even ask, when's the next video coming? Well, good question. Anyway, until next time, eat your cookies and don't ask Granny for the recipe. Toodles!